Google Photos starts charging for storage this week.
Rich DeMiro looks at alternative options in today's Tech Smart.
Google Photos started out as a completely free and unlimited service, but now that's changing. Users will have to pay if they store more than 15 gigabytes of photos. So today I'm taking a look at some alternatives for keeping your pictures in the cloud.
It's great to be back on campus talking with you all about Google Photos.
Google Photos started free, but now with 4 trillion photos stored by users worldwide, the free ride is over. Users will still get 15 gigabytes of free storage, but over that, and you'll have to pay, starting at $2 a month. The first alternative, iCloud. Apple gives users just 5 gigabytes of free storage, and if you're backing up an iPhone, it's probably already filled up. Extra storage starts at 99 cents a month, and Apple has great syncing and search, but this is good only if you're 100% Apple. Amazon Photos might be a good alternative, but only if you have a Prime membership. You can upload unlimited photos for free. But the bummer is when it comes to videos, you get just 5 gigabytes of storage. Also, if you cancel your Prime membership, you might have to start paying to store the photos you've already uploaded. Flickr is still around and now owned by SmugMug. For $60 a year, you can upload unlimited photos at full resolution, but videos are limited to 10 minutes max. Search and sort is just okay. Finally, Microsoft OneDrive will give you 5 gigabytes of storage free. Plans start at $2 a month, and there's an interesting family plan with lots of storage for everyone in your household. One downside, Microsoft doesn't have a dedicated Photos app. Now, although I'm not a huge fan of these changes, Google Photos organization and search functionality is tough to beat. I love how I can find pretty much any photo or video I've taken in seconds. All right, I've got all of these alternatives on my website. Just go to richontech.tv. I'm Rich DeMuro, and you are Tech Smart.